You know what? I think it's about time for an upgrade. So I've been sporting an EVGA GTX 960 4GB model for just over 3 years now, and now that we're two generations removed from that GPU, I decided it was time to upgrade. This video will look at how I did with my upgrade choice, as well as make some comparisons to the GTX 1080 at the end. To start off with though, why did I choose the card I did, the RTX 2070? Well, for starters, it fit in my budget of around $500, but it also offered several significant improvements over my existing card. The main one being 4GB of VRAM rather than 4, which is a bigger improvement than you might think. See, with system RAM, not having enough generally means your applications will run slower, as they have to swap data from system storage more often. But that isn't usually the case for GPU applications. If you utilize more VRAM than your card has, the application using that VRAM will straight up crash rather than just run slower. I've had plenty of Premiere Pro renders where I had to disable GPU acceleration as I didn't have enough VRAM to meet the demands of that particular render. Moving up to a much more powerful card with double the VRAM, and perhaps more importantly, that matched my PC build's color scheme, was a very useful upgrade for me. With that said, benchmarks. For the benchmarking, we'll be using PCMark, Cinebench, Blender, a 4K Premiere render, and VRMark. The last one might seem a bit out of place since we're testing workstation performance, but things like architecture and engineering are moving towards using VR, so it may be a useful benchmark to look at for overall workstation performance when thinking about potential future needs. With PCMark, which is testing general PC use, we saw a solid 900-point increase between our two GPUs. That increase isn't significant, but it's actually bigger than I was expecting, since faster storage, more RAM, and a faster CPU have a bigger impact on the type of things that PCMark tests, such as web browsing and video chat. Either way, it's a welcome improvement. Cinebench is a 3D rendering test, and, well, our significantly more powerful GPU actually performed worst. And I tested it multiple times just to be sure the slower number wasn't an anomaly. The difference is within what I would consider the margin of error, but I really don't know why we don't see noticeably higher numbers. If anyone has any ideas what might have gone wrong, please let me know in the comments and I might follow up in a future video. Whatever though. On Blender. With Blender, another 3D rendering benchmark, the GTX 960 scored in at 21 minutes and 37 seconds. Not that that matters though, because the RTX card didn't even complete the benchmark. The reason is that Blender doesn't yet support the version of CUDA on the newer RTX cards, CUDA being the programming interface used to control the cards. So that's a DNF for the RTX card. With Premiere, we do finally get to see a different story. The RTX card managed to render my 4K composition about 5% faster than the 960, a small but noticeable jump in performance. The composition was a compressed 4K file with Lumetri color corrections, Red Giant Cosmo, and Film Convert applied, being rendered as a 4K DNxHR file. Difference isn't huge, but again, remember that this newer card can render things that will crash on the 960. Lastly, the RTX 2070 finally gets a chance to totally trounce the GTX 960 with VRMark, where it scored over double what the older GPU managed. That means going from just barely being able to render 3D VR games at acceptable frame rates to being able to handle VR rendering without breaking a sweat. Pretty sweet. So, what does this all mean? Well, to answer that, let's talk about the start of this new GPU's name. RTX, changed from the GTX branding on previous generation cards. RTX is a new technology NVIDIA developed to allow for real-time ray tracing in video games. This allows for more accurate lighting, reflections, and shadows, but it comes at the cost of being very demanding. To compensate, NVIDIA included specially designed tensor cores in the RTX cards to handle the ray trace rendering. Those cores were previously only available in NVIDIA's Tesla GPUs, which are designed for AI and deep learning. That means the new cards are capable of running this RTX technology, but it also means general performance is cut back. The GTX 1080, which is right now retailing around the same price as the RTX 2070, has 2,560 CUDA cores compared to the 2070's 2,304. The 2070 also has a reduced core clock speed, but it does have significantly faster and wider bandwidth memory, which makes a really big difference in GPU performance. But how do all those specs translate to actual performance? Well, it depends on what type of applications you're looking at. For things that are primarily CUDA-based, like Premiere Accelerated Rendering, the two cards will trade blows, but when it comes to 3D rendering, the newer card can pretty consistently crush the 1080. That is, if your application supports rendering on the 2070, and yes, I'm adding you, Blender. That said, that leads us nicely into my conclusion for this video. The TLDR is get the GTX 1080 for tried and true performance and get the RTX 2070 for future performance. The GTX 1080 is a very solid card, and you can get them very cheap used or even new. Issues with RMA have been sorted out, unlike RTX cards, which have had issues as significant as reportedly spontaneously combusting. The 1080 sports more CUDA cores, which are supported by essentially every application that utilizes GPU acceleration. On the other hand, the RTX 2070 is looking ahead with its addition of Tensor cores. Those Tensor cores are untapped hardware that could be utilized to consistently give the RTX cards an edge over previous generations in workstation applications. There are already developer tools available to take advantage of those Tensor cores, so it's just a matter of time before we start seeing updates in popular GPU accelerated applications like Blender and Premiere Pro to utilize that hardware and get additional performance boosts. Either way though, you can't really go wrong, as both cards are great options, and either one is certainly a fantastic upgrade from an older card like my GTX 960. Anyway, that's it for this video. If you liked this video, if it was useful, if it was an interesting comparison and analysis, hit that like button. If not, feel free to hit that dislike button. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave those down in the comment section down below. And of course, if you want to see more videos like this one, please go ahead and hit that subscribe button.